God, brothers and sisters, praise God once again. Today is another beautiful day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. And I just want to encourage all of you today by telling you that Jesus loves you, and okay, anyway, don't worry. So, Jesus loves you, and he's coming very soon, and we are looking forward to his coming. He's promised us, and he will do it, and he's not slack concerning his promise. He said, and he's going to do it, and we are looking forward to this great day. Despite all the things which are happening in the world right now, despite all the misfortunes, all the confusions which are in the world and all the things which are happening, it's about time that we realize that God has given us his mind. He has given us his mind to be able to see things in his own way. When you hear somebody has the mind of Christ, it literally means you can be able to focus out how God could be thinking. How would he be calculating his things? And that's why sometimes you look at things and some agitate you, others they make you happy, others you feel pity. That is a character of God. You're literally having the mind of God. Think about the times that you are not even saved. Think about those times. How are you calculating things? Were you behaving the same way? Not at all. I'm very sure there's so much which changed the moment that you got saved, because you got a new mind and a new heart. So you don't feel the same way you used to feel from your heart. You don't think the same way you used to think. It's like some settings have been changed. That's why the Bible says that we are God's workmanship, created unto good works. So the moment you're already created, then you're created unto good works, because now you have a mind, a new mind, the mind of Christ. So the mind of Christ is all about good works. It's all about doing good, saving the people, helping here, helping there. The mind of Christ is not about crime, is not about stealing. Christ will not be thinking about doing evil things. So if we have a mind of Christ, then you can be able to understand that some things have changed and you feel differently. You think differently, you do things differently. You're not the way you used to be back in those days. And that's how you know that for sure there's something which transformed in me. But if you say that you got saved and you're just the same old way, nothing really changed, the things that you do are just the same things that you used to do before, you don't feel any guilt about it, you don't feel any pressure about it, you see, our lives are a life of testimony. The reason why we don't get saved and go to heaven immediately is because we have to live a life of testimony in this world. Think about it. If Jesus could be going abusing people in the streets, even if, yes, he cannot go to hell, but at the end of the day, many people could not have loved that kind of testimony. They could have said, this guy who abuses people in the streets is the one who is telling us to be okay, to be good people. Or think about, forget even about Jesus, think about the disciples. If they went on killing people in the streets and they tell people, oh, get saved, could there be anyone who could believe them? You see, the reason why we live a good testimony is so that we can be able to influence others into wanting to have the same lifestyle that we have. Think about the early apostles. What really happened with them? They used to share what they had. They could share among each other. There was no one who was poor among them. There was no one who slept hungry. Nowadays, we have churches full. Pastors driving Range Rovers, nice cars and wearing nice suits, but there are members in there who have not even eaten. Is that really Christ-like? Do you think Jesus would be happy that a part of his body is in pain without, hungry, and another part of his body is full to the excess that they don't even know where they'll take some. You see, we have to ask ourselves, everything that you do, is it really the way God intended it to be? If Jesus was sitting down there, would you do what you're doing right now as a Christian? Would you sit down there and let Jesus watch? Because if you wouldn't do it in front of Jesus, then there's something wrong. You have to change it. You have to leave a testimony. So that's exactly what I just felt. Let me encourage you with and tell you that we have on the mind of Christ, and we have been transformed by his blood. We have been given a new heart and a new mind so that you can be able to speak and do what is right and give a good testimony. Are you giving a good testimony? God bless you.